This man here named Abida Bakar changed my life in 10 minutes with his tragic story. When I was at the hospital, Tel HaShomer, I saw a group of people in tears, so I decided to join in and listen. He started to tell us about his story, about how he lost his son and wife right in front of him in a miklat of Kibbutz Be'eri. After telling us the story, he goes on saying how each one of us should appreciate family, life, and the value of living. He mentioned that he used to bring his family to expensive restaurants, and his wife would get mad for spending so much money. He would always say times like these were priceless, and money can come back, but tragedies like these can't. I was in tears after his speech. I approached him, and I just let myself go with continuous tears. He told me not to cry. "Look at me," he said. "I'm smiling. I lived the best years with my son and wife." And he points at his daughter and says, "Thank God I still have her. I learned this lesson. A valuable lesson I learned about this is people look around, people say, wow, money, I'm stressed, money this. We have to realize that each one of us in this room have family. We have stuff that people don't have. We have family, we have brothers, we have sisters. And who would rather money over connections with your siblings like these, with your parents? Just, it's a crazy lesson. And the fact I saw this guy able to smile like that and show me like how appreciative he was gave me really a valuable lesson. And yeah.
On October 7th, Hamas terrorists infiltrated Kibbutz Be'eri with RPGs, grenades, and AK-47s. In this house, where the bullet is found in the wall, I saw children's toys, baby shoes, and the room was completely unrecognizable. The wall where I retrieved this bullet was scattered with the bullet marking and charcoal. They took no mercy on the lives that were inside of these homes. It is our job to remember our brothers and sisters that were taken away from us on October 7th. We spent our last Shabbat in the army base of Netiv Asara. In this image, we can see just a smaller teaser of what we experienced all night on the Shabbat. As the clock approached 8 o'clock, when we would usually sit at the Shabbat table, we saw hundreds of Hamas rockets being fired right above our head. Some of the rockets were even flying back towards Gaza. Because we were at the border on a makeshift base, we had nowhere to sleep. So me and Gad decided that it was a good idea to fall asleep in the car. Gad and I ended up falling asleep in the car, and when we woke up, we see a counter missile of the Kibbutz Be'eri just 3 feet away from the car. If that missile had landed any closer to the car, it would have blown up.